Hello, welcome to this exam question video. Today we are going to be looking at EPOC, or as it's also known, excess post-exercise oxygen consumption. And we are looking at it at a GCSE level. It does go into a little bit more detail when you get to A level and beyond, but for today we are going to be looking at the fundamentals of this term and its effect on the body before or after exercise. And in this scenario, what we're looking at here is a subject, Rosie, her breathing immediately after intensive exercise. Now that's quite an important point there, intensive exercise, because EPOC does occur if we were finishing submaximal or low to moderate intensity exercise, but it would take on a slightly different shape, form, it would be slightly different quantities and for durations. So this is quite an important point to note down. It's intensive exercise because it gives a clue as to the challenges that the body has been placed under, which is mainly anaerobic. If we are completing intensive work, then we're obviously going to be in an energy deficit or an oxygen deficit where we have to respire anaerobically, releasing energy from our foods without the presence of sufficient oxygen. So what sort of challenges does that actually put on the body? Well, first of all, the phosphocreatine stores, which are responsible for the first 10 seconds of energy supply, they're going to be depleted. So we know that we're going to have to be putting those back together. We also know that there's going to be some development of lactic acid accumulation in the muscles as well, because as we respire anaerobically, we know that as the glucose is broken down, we know that lactic acid is given off as a byproduct. And there might also be a build-up or a slow build-up of CO2. Now, we know carbon dioxide is produced as a result of aerobic exercise, but depending on how intense this exercise and how long this exercise was going for, there would have been an element of aerobic exercise as an undercurrent. Now, not the main supplier of energy, but there would have been some occurring. Therefore, there would be some CO2 being produced as well. So we'll start with the first part of this question, which is what actually happens to Rosie's breathing immediately after exercise? Well, breathing can be impacted in two different ways. We've got the breathing rate and the breathing depth. So the frequency of our breaths, and then in each one of those breaths, how deep do we breathe in? How much air do we put into our lungs? How much air do we exhale? So if we have just finished intensive exercise, we know that Rosie will be maintaining her heightened or increased breathing rate. It would have increased from rest to her peak period of exercise, and we would have maintained that level. It wouldn't suddenly drop and then spike again. It would maintain from whatever level she finished that intense exercise at. From there, it would then start to trail off, but EPOC, it would start off with that maintenance of increased or heightened breathing rate. Alongside that, there would also be deeper breathing. So during that exercise, it's likely that Rosie would have experienced, you know, a little bit more mechanical control over her inspiration and exhalation, increasing her tidal volume, or tidal volume being the volume of air that we breathe in or out per breath. So it would have been deeper breaths with more being exhaled, therefore more being inhaled each breath. Again, that would have been maintained. Now what could be interesting to see on the actual graph would be if her frequency of breathing were to gradually decrease, that would give more time in between each breath. Now, in that time, it might be that Rosie is able to take slightly deeper breaths. So we might start to see breathing depth or tidal volume increase in the initial stages of EPOC, but that's a nuance. What you want to be saying is the breathing rate is maintained at a high level and we breathe deep in our inhalation and our exhalation, so we have an increased tidal volume as well. Now the reasons, why would our breathing stay at this heightened level? Well, we have to be thinking about putting our body back to its resting conditions, putting us back into homeostasis, and it's reverting any changes that occurred because of this anaerobic intensive exercise. Well, at the start of intensive exercise, we know that there is an oxygen deficit or an oxygen debt. So why do we continue with this EPOC? Because we are repaying that oxygen debt. There wasn't enough at the start, therefore we had to complete anaerobic activities. So now that we are reducing our physical demands, we've got the opportunity to put extra oxygen back in to reset our body. So repaying oxygen debt or oxygen deficit. Second, we start to break down and remove the lactic acid. Now, obviously, this process could occur for a few minutes or a few hours, even a few days after the exercise, depending on how intense that was, but the process can begin during EPOC, this excess post-exercise oxygen consumption immediately following the exercise. What we also have is a resupply of oxygen into the muscle. So we have hemoglobin in the blood and we have myoglobin in the muscle, and these are responsible for changing oxygen out of the blood and into the muscle. Well, following intense exercise, there's going to be a short supply of oxygen in the muscle. Myoglobin isn't going to have much oxygen with it. Therefore, as the blood and the hemoglobin comes around with this fresh batch of oxygen because of this EPOC, we're going to start resupplying the muscle, resupplying the myoglobin with oxygen, ready for the next bout of exercise. So we've got the slow or the initial breakdown of lactate, we've got the replenishment of myoglobin with oxygen, or replenishment of the muscle oxygen stores, we've got the repayment of the oxygen deficit that happened at the start, and we've also got the resynthesis of phosphocreatine, that fuel source that we spoke about earlier, which supplies the body with its first 10 seconds worth of fuel. So we use that oxygen to enable aerobic processes, which can release the energy, which can resynthesize those phosphocreatine molecules. And by doing all of that, we can start to recover the body from the anaerobic work that it just produced. And that's that. So EPOC, excess post-exercise oxygen consumption, what happens after exercise? We maintain an increased breathing rate and we maintain a deeper or greater tidal volume in comparison to resting levels. Why do we do this? Because we've just completed anaerobic activity. Therefore, we need to repay the oxygen deficit that was there at the start. We replenish the muscle's oxygen stores. We start to take out the lactic acid and we can start to regenerate our phosphocreatine stores all in time for our next exercise session. So I hope you found that useful, and I'll see you again in the next one. Bye for now.